Hey guys, Ryan here for Bender Wins. Hope everyone's doing well today. Here with your daily free picks. So today's video, guys, brought to you by betopenly.com. If you guys haven't checked them out yet, what are you waiting for? Seriously, check them out, guys. Tons of value. Normal sportsbook, you're laying minus 110. Reduced juice, you're laying minus 105. With BetOpenly, guys, you're just paying a 1% commission only on bets you win. When you lose, you pay no juice. Okay, so check them out. I know like few of you guys who have checked them out, loving them so far. So I do appreciate the feedback. Thank you. All right. So yesterday we went 4-0 on our free picks masterclass. We won another two games, went 2-0. So a total 6-0 on the day. We started the day Washington Tampa with the under. Easy cover. I then gave you guys, you know what, not only do we go 4-0 for you guys for free picks, but we got a nice underdog too, right? Plus 135 Minnesota over Chicago. Again, guys, the public was so heavy on Chicago yesterday. I told you guys that, right? So 32% of bets on Minnesota, only 32% of bets, but 77% of money. Okay, that is sharp money all day long. That's not hard to identify. Above and beyond that, guys, there was steam. What is going on? Bender needs a haircut, like really, really bad. The COVID hair is getting out of control. And Mrs. Wins is starting to get on his case. And I don't blame her because I look homeless. All right. Also, six different system indicators on that Minnesota-Chicago game. All right. Next game, guys, was the Yankee. We had Yankee. It was a two-unit play. We had it two different ways. It was two bets. We had them to win by half a run in the first five innings. They did quite handily. And we had him to win the game. I really went out on a limb at minus 245, didn't I? But no, there was value there. It was a lot of value. And I mean, I think that game proved it. Masterclass plays. We had Cleveland, Chicago going under 8.5. Again, guys, fantastic Wrigley system. I'm going to tell, the reason I bring that up is I want to tell you guys something about that because you guys asked me questions about live betting, okay? Next game, guys, Pittsburgh and Cincinnati. We took Pittsburgh. We moved that line to +2.5. We didn't need it. They lost 1-0. So we got a cover there. And again, to move that line, a very low total game. We were expecting a low scoring game. And to get 2.5 points with low offense, and we're only laying minus 145 on that, it was fantastic value. But I want to talk about Cleveland, Chicago, because sometimes you guys ask me, you know, what's my impression of, live betting? Okay, do I like it? Do I live bet? For the short answer, guys, the short answer is no, not really. Okay. So I look at live betting as A, the juice is just too high. It's too high. Okay. Secondly, the computer algorithms that they use are very, very, very strong. So, I mean, unless you have information, okay, information that is actionable, that you believe you can not only beat these great computers, but the increased juice, then I say stay away. And again, you might be able to justify in your mind why you think something is so, but let's make sure that you're not chasing in a game. It's a different way of chasing, right? And again, with live betting, guys, if you're going to do it, really, really be exercising that bankroll management. Okay. But I am going to talk to you guys about a couple situations where I do live bet. Okay. I said that the main reason I would live bet would either be to hedge a bet if I saw a major momentum swing or something that has changed. And that brings me to the next point is the main reason is if something changes in the game fundamentally, okay? If something fundamentally changes in a game, I will live bet. And yesterday was one of those examples where I made a live bet. And that was in the Cleveland-Chicago game. Looking at in-game weather reports, guys, the wind was churning, and it actually went from a crosswind halfway through the game. Okay, halfway through the game, went from a crosswind to wind blowing straight in. Okay, straight in wind. At this point, I'm looking at it and say, okay, you know, very, very strong possibility there's not going to be any more home runs. And I was able to find a very, very favorable high line where I had to pay a little bit of juice, but I found a very favorable high line in that game where I felt comfortable putting a live bet. So, I mean, that is a fundamental situational change where basically something has changed. A variable has changed and it's given me a significant advantage. In this case, guys, that wind blowing straight in, it was a crosswind. It was blowing a little bit in, but more so of a crosswind, and that wind direction changed. And now it presented me with an opportunity, and that's an opportunity that I'm going to take live betting. But for the most part, guys, I stay away from it. Okay. I stay away from it. Again, I don't have the systems and the algorithms and all this stuff built that I can build like a super, that I can beat a supercomputer. And I've talked to people about these computers, guys. And, you know, if you think it's some guy in a room, like clicking a button or something like that, being like, oh, let's move the line on this game. It's not, guys. You have to go up against like literally a supercomputer. So best of luck, because I'm not going to take on a computer real time. Yeah. So, anyways, guys, so a good day yesterday. I wanted to bring that up. I have three plays for you guys. Masterclass. I have another four plays for you guys. A couple different props in Masterclass. So football prop, basketball props. But I have three plays for you guys. So, I do want to mention as well, really, really quickly before I get into it. I know, you know, yesterday and a couple times this week, actually, you know, I brought up like, you know, little stories or little tidbits and stuff like that about my past. So I think you guys have liked that for the most part. And, you know, I want this not only to be educational in terms of learning about sports betting, but, you know, I want you guys to, you know, maybe get an idea of how I kind of got started, how I did it start to finish. You know, and I have lots of stories. I mean, lots and lots and lots of stories. I told you guys, you know, I placed my first sports bet when I was 10 years old. I won. I talked about yesterday. I bet it was a no brainer. They were all like, I don't know what they would have been like equivalent, but they're probably like all minus 300 favorites. And I just parlayed them together and whatever. I mean, that's what they probably should have been, but, all right, so I'll do more of those. I definitely will. Maybe I'll do one tomorrow for you guys. But let's get into the game for today, guys. All right, so after a great day like that, how do I break this news to you guys? I don't have an NFL play for you. Okay, I know it's Thursday. I know the end of the week is here. I know we're excited, and you know we want to get our bets in on Thursday football. But again, guys, I'm not a tout. Okay, I'm not a tout. I'm not, you know, a midget from Vegas who sells whale picks, because I'm not going to say his name on here again. But, you know, that's on me, guys. And straight up, I tell you guys, you know, if I can't find value in a game, I can't find value in a game. Okay, and I'll walk you through this, guys, and I'll tell you my line of thinking. Okay, I'm going to tell you my line of thinking. I came on here before, guys. I said, you know, Thursday favorites. They cover 58% of the time, right? That's good. We like that. Thursday favorites cover 58% of the time. Okay, that's pretty actionable. But on the flip side of the coin, guys, I have a money line system. Road team. Gonna cover this game. Or not cover, sorry. They win this game outright. But 48% of the time. Okay, well, that puts a little bit of a damper on that. All right, so I know I got systems on the totals here. I got system on the total. Because I know, I've talked about this before, I think a while back, Masterclass guys, when I gave you guys in the last video, I'll give you nine systems, talk about this. Games early in the season, games going over after both teams go under, okay? That's a system, okay? I won't go through the entire details. Masterclass guys have it. They pay good money for it. There you go. But really good system. Hits in the 60% range, close to 60%, okay? That looks good for the over, right? No. We have wind in a division game with a nice total on the under, okay? That hits close to 60%. There is too much contradictory data. There is no clear money distribution winner in this game. There is no clear steam on either side. There's no reverse line moves on either side. There's steam for the over and there's steam for the under. So to me, guys, to me, and again, maybe there's some of you guys are out there and you know, you're better at handicapping football than me. I don't know. Maybe that you have a play on this game. But for me, guys, I'm looking at this game and I'm saying, if I give you guys a pick, if I bet on this game, it's no better than, you know, spinning a ball around a roulette table or flipping a coin, because that's all it would be. Okay. So I'm sorry, guys. I know you're here for a football play. I don't have one for you. All right. But, you know, that's how it is here, right? We're betting value. We're betting value. And, you know, I tell you guys this, and I know that, you know, I have to kind of adjust my mind sometimes, because I'm like, you know, about value. I make a living. It's my job, right? But I know, like, you know, you guys here, you want the excitement, you know, the excitement of sports betting too. And again, I totally get that. And, you know, but I've always said, that being said, I've always said, guys, you know, it doesn't hurt to lay off these games, you know, especially Sunday night games and Monday night games. When you don't have an opinion, lay off, right? Save yourself that money. So anyways, guys, I do have three plays for you guys. No, I don't. I lied. I have four plays for you guys. I have four. See, they're bonus play. All right. First play, guys, we're going to be in baseball here. So first play, New York Mets and Phillies. Okay. New York Mets and Phillies going under 8, laying -120. Okay. So New York Mets, Phillies under 8, -120. Next game, guys, we have Minnesota and Chicago. Okay. So Minnesota, Chicago, couple nice system indicators in this game. Gambolino behind home plate is 55.2% under umpire. Decent sample size. I actually had him, it's funny. And maybe I didn't update this. I try to update my databases all the time. I have him as like an up and coming under umpire, but I think that's been there for years because he's got quite a decent total now. But we're going to take under 9 Minnesota, Chicago. Next game, guys, Arizona and LA. So Arizona, LA, we're also going to be taking the under. A little bit of a theme there, right? We're going to be taking the under as well. So going under 10. We lost this line a little bit because it was 10.5, but that doesn't bother me too much. We'll take it under at 10. The three different steam bets in this, and I do like the under. A couple system indicators on that under as well. So we are going to go ahead and do that. And then I have one more pick for you guys. We're going to do something similar to what we did yesterday. Okay, now we're going to be back on the Yankees. It's not a two-unit play today. Okay, it's not a two-unit play, but we're going to break it up into two plays. So they're going to be half-unit plays. Okay, so I'm going to tell you how we're going to do this, guys. We're not going first five again. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to go a half unit on the money line. Okay, a half unit on the money line. We're laying -225. Then we're going to go a half unit on the run line, -1.5. So -1.5, we're going to have to pay -120 for that. Okay. The Blue Jays historically have never done well against the Yankees. They haven't. Okay. And I don't need databases because I'm a Jays fan and it kills me to bet against them. And I'll be honest, I watched maybe an inning of that game yesterday because I don't want to see it. I don't want to see the Blue Jays, which I love, get the shit kicked out of them. And I knew they were going to. I didn't know they were going to. I thought with a very high level of probability, because there's no such thing as knowing in sports. But anyways, guys, they're just not on the same level here, okay? Teoscar Hernandez be back in the lineup. Judge is back. I mean, yeah, at this point in their careers, obviously, I mean, Hernandez, great player, but Judge adds so much more to that team. You can't get in front of the Yankee freight train, okay? When they're rolling, when they got, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 game winning streaks going, you can't get in their way. You can't, okay? I mean, again, if you were capping this right now, you know, I would say, hey, you know, that's fine. Like, you know, if you don't feel their value on the Yankees on your end, don't bet them. But sure as hell, don't get in their way, okay? There's a few teams like that in this league. When they get rolling, you don't get in their way. And the Yankees are one of them, guys. So we're gonna go with them instead of getting their way. So anyways, guys, four plays there. Sorry about NFL, but if you guys have been here for a while on the channel, it's not the first time I've done this. It's the first time I've disappointed people. It's not the first time I've done this, guys. But again, you know, that's part of this business. Okay. It's part of this business. It's about value. It's about making money. You know, I'm sure if you're really interested, there's probably 1600 other, you know, picks on YouTube that'll tell you who their lock of the year is going to be on tonight's game. But anyways, not me. All right, so that's it today. Really, really happy to have a nice bounce back, go 4-0 for you guys yesterday, 6-0 for Masterclass, guys. And yeah, if you guys are interested in Masterclass, the link is down below. You can sign up to through benderwins.com. So if you go to benderwins.com, that is for email, okay? So you will get your picks emailed to you every single day. So all the picks, Masterclass and free play, you'll get all those picks emailed to you every day. As well, you'll get all the Masterclass videos emailed as well. If you want to watch the Masterclass videos in terms of when I verbally give out the picks and the videos, you can do that by joining Masterclass right through YouTube. And that link is just below my Bender Wins link down in the description. All right. So again, if you guys are interested, we're doing well. We're doing well. I mean, all in all, we're hitting at the very, very high end of where we would expect to be hitting in both Masterclass and the free plays. So it's been fun. All right. So anyways, guys, if you're interested, check it out. It's again, it's $100 a month. Again, you know, I think it works out to like $3 a day. So, you know, I think for, you know, the education alone, especially considering like I gave out 9 systems last week in NFL. You know, some of them I mentioned today, but 9 systems, and this is literally like tens of thousands of dollars you'd be up just betting $100 per game, just following these systems. So anyway, and even in today, guys, today, like those systems I talked about, a few of them are actually relevant today. So had you looked and said, okay, yeah, you know what? I like this team. One of these systems might've been able to get you off it and maybe save you a loss as well. Because, you know, winning is great, but also saving a loss is pretty good too. There's not many times, guys, where we talk ourselves out of a bet, okay? And that bet loses, where we celebrate like we won a game. No, we don't. But I mean, we should, right? Because technically, we kind of did. So anyways, guys, that is it for today. I appreciate it. Very happy about yesterday for you guys. And, you know, I think, like I said, maybe tomorrow I'll share a really quick story for you and try to keep the video a little bit shorter because I don't want to take up your whole day. So anyways, guys, really appreciate it. And as always, have a very lucky day.